And coming up next, we have Timmy Alexis Carrington Ward with Here She Is.
Well, now the lockdown's over, I'm receiving gentlemen callers. Cheery bye! Oh, here she is. Don't you just hate waiting for the bus?
When's it due?
Excuse me, I'm not pregnant.
I know, I meant when's the bus due?
Oh, sorry. 10 minutes.
Thanks. Christ, you silly fuck. Hello, is it?
Oh, hi, it's Nina Wadia.
Well, I know Nina Mishkov, but she's let herself go lately. Seems to be a trend. I said it. Anyway, how do I know you?
Well, remember? We met at the doctor's office the other day.
Excuse me, hi. Is it possible to make an appointment to see a doctor, please?
How about 10 tomorrow?
10? I only need one. You know, no wonder the NHS is in a state. Care now.
Do you know, the other week, my husband tried to humiliate me by telling all his family I was rubbish in bed. Imagine his surprise when they all disagreed.
You're watching Here She Is. Here are the headlines.
We start off tonight with a recent health survey which has revealed that 6 out of 7 dwarfs are not happy.
Pop star Elton John is said to be in great distress after sending his hearing aid to be repaired 3 weeks ago. He hasn't heard a thing since.
A clockmaker in Manchester was too ill to receive his OBE by the Queen today. His wife informed us that he's suffering with a dicky ticker.
Detectives are still investigating the death of a man from an overdose from Viagra 10 years ago. His relatives say it's still very hard.
And that's the end of the news for tonight. So it's good night from me.
And it's good night from her.
Good night.
Welcome, Nina Wadia. To my bed.
Are you going to be nice to me?
We'll see. But first, let's have some drink.
Okay.
There you go. Cheers.
Cheers.
So, I can see the lockdown's been cruel to you. It's been cruel to me as well, darling. Normally I can get celebrities on my bed. Nina, you yes. have done such a vast array of work, haven't you? You've
yeah.
done everything. So what do you do now it's all over?
Cheeky piece.
So where did you train?
I trained at a terrible drama school.
Yeah, we could tell.
The fact is, I've seen your act.
You were a proper actress at the beginning and did theatre, didn't you?
Yes, I did.
What were you doing in the theatre if we have to talk about your theatre work?
I was at Theatre Royal Stratford East. I did a bunch of...
What were you doing? Usherette? Just one connecto. Because you did Holby City, didn't you?
Yes.
Did you keep thinking people were calling your name at Holby City?
What do you mean?
Nina, Nina. That's as good as it gets, love.
Some jokes are timeless.
But also you did Doctors.
Yes.
But don't worry, not a lot of people watch Doctors, so you got away with that one.
I'm afraid I have to agree with that.
Goodness gracious me.
Yes.
That was breakthrough telly for the Indian community, wasn't
yeah,
it?
Yeah, very much so, very much so. And in fact, to be honest, I only thought the Indian community would get it, but actually the whole of the UK embraced it and it was amazing.
You didn't like it? No, I didn't like it.
No, is it because it was Indians mostly?
I don't like Indians.
No, I thought as much. It's me with Bollywood.
I'm over them.
Oh, you are awful, but I like you.
How did that come about?
So I was doing a show at Theatre Royal Stratford East called Do You Eat With Your Fingers, which I'd co-written with a bunch of friends. I then met Sanjeev Bhaskar, who was doing a show with Nitin Sawhney called The Secret Asians. And he wrote me a very funny letter as like a 15-year-old dyslexic boy saying he wanted to meet me. And, you know, I thought this is a funny person, whoever's written this. So I went and met him and we worked together.
Hang on. You went to meet a 15-year-old boy?
No, he wrote it like he was.
What's that? Hashtag me too, isn't it?
Oh my God.
I've got an exclusive here, guys.
What you need is a bucket of cold water thrown on you.
So I went and saw his show. And then he said, do you want to do a show together? And we worked together at the Oval House. And that's when the producer of Goodness Gracious Me was looking for another girl to be part of the show, and they said, would you like to come on board?
All aboard the Skylark!
You all wrote it?
Yes.
How did you do that? I don't say pens.
No, the ideas were thrown around the table.
And would you write separate sketches
yeah,
for each
thing? People would get inspired by things that were put out there, and then if you wanted to and you got inspired enough, you'd go away and you'd write it and bring it back the next day. And so Monday to Thursday was the kind of rehearsal and writing time, and Fridays we used to do Friday Night Lives, which was really cool.
What were the other cast members like? Because it sounds to me a little bit like you were brought together to make a band.
Sort of. I knew Kulvinder because we'd done radio together in Manchester. Sanjeev lived around the corner from me and we'd already worked together before. Meera I'd never met before. It was a bit of a mixture of some people we knew, some people we didn't.
I can sort of tell you haven't seen a Meera before.
Why am I here?
I'm asking myself this.
Why?
How many series did you do of that?
We did, I think, 3 series and a couple of specials, something like that.
Did you finish it? Did they finish it? Who finished it? Because I'd like to shake their hand.
You're very bitter, aren't you?
I think we wanted to go out on a high. We were loving it, but we were all getting offered other work. I got offered Perfect World, which is a comedy Tiger Aspect we're making.
Sorry, I'm just struggling with you got offered other work.
That's all.
I got offered a job to work with Dennis Pennis. He's just brilliant. So I just thought it'd be nice to go and do something different.
Something funny, yeah?
That's not fair.
Well, you missed one thing between I got pregnant and had my first child.
So, you've had a kid. You've had 2 kids. Have you had 2 kids before you got EastEnders?
No, I had 1 kid, then I did EastEnders, then another kid.
During EastEnders?
Yeah.
Oh, that will explain your size.
Did you have to audition for EastEnders?
No. They approached me with the part and they said, we want you to create Pauline Fowler but funny.
Should they be like that or like that?
Had they seen you in other work before?
Yes.
And they probably thought, oh, she'll improve if we it's ongoing.
You bastard.
I think you were in 6 years.
Yeah, I went in for 6 months. And I stayed.
I'm sorry, but you must have some pictures of the producers in that show that you've threatened to show somewhere to last that long. So how was that, being such a horrible homophobic woman?
I took them the storyline because, you know, I have Muslim friends and this story...
Sorry, again, I'm struggling. You've got friends.
Don't you start.
I heard stories about how difficult it is to be Muslim and gay.
Yeah.
And we were playing a Muslim family. So I asked them to research into it a bit more. And they said, yeah, we love this idea. Love this idea of this storyline. And so the storyline was born from there. But when they told me that they were going to make me really homophobic and nasty, I was really upset about it because I was like, but because I know that fans sometimes don't see the difference. They genuinely don't know that you're playing a character.
So you wouldn't have to worry about that. Have you got fans?
Once a bitch, always a bitch.
It's such an odd place to work because even though you are all part of the cast, and it's a big cast, like 40 odd people, you don't really get to see a lot of the other people unless there's a wedding or a death, you know. Yeah. The rest of the time you might be in the marketplace or something like that.
They must have been around your scenes a lot because you f***ing died every scene you were in.
How dare you speak to me like that?
Have you ever been asked back?
Yes, I've been asked back a couple of times.
I mean, and this is the problem with that soap.
Yeah.
They don't raise their game. They're in trouble.
That's right. It's the truth that hurts.
You were also playing a caterer in Bend It Like Beckham.
Yes.
So you took your work home with you.
And I'm so glad to see you not only kept your gorgeous figure, but you've added so much to it.
Also, you've done Mr. and Mrs.
Oh my God.
And congratulations. I can't believe you ever got a mister in your life.
I suppose looks aren't everything.
You have been offered an OBE.
Yes.
You haven't been given it yet, have you?
No.
That was for entertainment and charity, wasn't it?
That's right, yes.
Yeah, because you bought a lot of clothes from charity shops, haven't you?
We're just trying to run a charity shop.
You've also been a complete cult. I mean, people say I'm a complete cult. But you've done Doctor Who, the
11th
Hour. Now, did you play a horrible, monster-y type thing, or did you have to go into makeup?
Oh, you miserable bitch!
I played Dr. Ramsden. This is just a field day for you. She ran the lunatic hospital. And she got eaten by an alien that crawled out of the vent.
Bloody hell. I hope he was hungry.
Chin up, darling. Both of them.
You're doing something quite special now, aren't you?
I'm working with Stephen Merchant on his new comedy, The Offenders.
What are you playing in that?
So I play a Sri Lankan mum.
Oh, okay.
It's a really nice part. It's really fun. And we've got Christopher Walken.
I do always look at you and think, she's got a really nice part.
Missy, shall we find out what part we're talking about first? Or you start gaffing?
Do you know how I end my interviews?
Yes, with a selfie.
She said it. Let's have a selfie. Honestly, it's been... You are such a lovely, lovely lady. I don't believe what Mirror says about you. So we're going to look bottom right.
Okay.
I said that to my husband last night.
Should they be like that or like that?
Here we are, girl. You all right?
Yes, that was a bit of a bumpy ride.
I said that to my husband last night. So, I take things off the television and I put a voice to them.
Okay.
This particular one is Shirley Bassey. It's from one of her documentaries. Now, my thing with Shirley Bassey is Shirley Bassey is not of this world.
Right.
In that she doesn't go on the train. She got on the underground cab. She'd have, I go on an underground cab, and she wouldn't have a ticket. She'd have, I've got an invitation to go on the underground cab. They're all so affected, aren't they? And transatlantic, the accent and everything. So
everything is like, I've got a gown. I'm wearing a gown, not a dress, and all of that.
All right.
So this is just, I love her. So here we go.
Very sexy gown.
Sexy gown.
That I've gone through. One particular.
Talking about her
David
gown.
Made holes. In
holes.
Holes. One just. Just
is
around
she going
my
to
navel.
Point at every spot on the earth?
So I felt like putting a diamond,
a ruby.
But it was sexy, you know,
sexy.
Sort of without being kind of over the top. You know.
It wasn't over the top.
And
I want to sit like.
I was about. Oh, yeah. I was playing the Plaza.
I'm playing
York,
the Plaza.
Plaza Hotel, the Empire Room.
Yeah.
And I was introducing this song called "I Capricorn," and then I happened to say, "I am a Capricorn."
She said it.
And then the voice. Said something I didn't hear, and I said, "Excuse me, I am a Capricorn," and I appeared, and it was Ava Gardner.
It was Ava Gardner,
and looking gorgeous.
Looking gorgeous.
And so, fellow Capricorn, but I couldn't get to her because she wasn't ringside. So what I did, I hitched up.
She wasn't ringside.
And
not. She wasn't by the stage.
And as I passed each man who might have been tempted, you know, to touch one
so
of the.
So she's got to go under the tables to get to her.
Bare flesh. No touching. Watch it. You know, so I was
watch it.
To her and then
look
I
at her story.
The gardener and I said, "Congratulations."
I mean, that's her story. What about a congratulations?
That's
great
amazing.
Story. Thanks, Shirley.
I wish I had stories like that.
Believe me. Earlier today, I thought the same when you were telling your stories, girl. Right, and this is now her dresser.
Okay.
So they're. Sexy and
they're sexy.
Very heavy.
All right.
Very heavy. Yeah. She can't be moved. But
he's had a perm.
Yes. Where's he from?
It's like really like
I wish he'd go
gymnast.
Back. What about it's like making it for a gymnast?
But it's like really like making for a gymnast.
That, now this is my last one, which is my favourite. This couldn't be any more. I gotta work.
Okay.
On the underground cab. This is so just talking la-di-da in her world.
I actually go to work with a gown in a shopping bag.
I gotta work with a gown in a shopping bag.
Is,
I mean, what about a shopping bag?
Tight,
if she does.
One leg is beautifully beaded and it has a chiffon. It has body.
It has body.
I love it.
And look, I can't believe I'm going to say bosom.
How does one say? She has black pizzas around her.
Look at.
A bosom.
Oh, she can't believe she said bosom.
Embroidered pieces.
Embroidered pieces.
So that I wear nothing underneath and it's long sleeves.
It's long sleeves.
And then this chiffon skirt that goes
and
around
the leg
my
comes
waist.
Out.
And the leg comes out, you know. I quite like that.
She quite like that.
I think I'm a stripper at heart, really. I love to take things off.
I think I'm a stripper at heart. I love taking things off. And then just with the curtain, because she's so
it.
Like, what do I do now?
Yeah.
Let's have a look at that last little bit.
So that I wear nothing underneath.
I've got
sleeves. And then this chiffon skirt that goes around
and the leg comes out.
The leg comes out, you know. I quite
and
like
watch
that.
And watch her do this.
I think I'm a stripper at heart.
Curtain, really. Just like Anne.
I love to take things off.
Where's she gone? Speaking of strippers, I'd like to strip her down a peg or two. I said it. I'm going to go and see her now.
It's all you have to do.
Oi, what are you?
What the fuck? Oh, it's one of those Timmy toilet shows. Oh, goodness gracious, shit me. City bitch. I never missed a heartbeat. Just sitting in the backseat. Yeah. East End is said to be dark and depressing, but this makes it look like a fairy tale. Each and every night. One thing I'm always dreaming of. I'm gonna squeeze and hold tight. I can't be here much longer watching this shit. I've gotta get back to Bristol and film The Offenders with Stephen Merchant. Who is way more talented and taller.
You said it.
You're watching Here She Is.
Hang on, I haven't wear it yet.
Okay.
Hang on.
Was that the cue?
Yeah.
Hugh.
All right, this is going really well, isn't it, so far? Off to a cracking start. Okay.